I have another story time before I go to bed. I thought I would speak about this one. Let me see. I have so many stories, so many, and I don't know. They're all interesting. They all are. I'll give you a short one. I'm gonna do a story time about my high school sweetheart. I won't say names at all, but once upon a time, there was a girl. She was sheltered. It was me. I was sheltered, as I feel I was sheltered. And I was sheltered, I feel, because I was the only girl my mom had. Now, being that I was the only girl, I couldn't do what my brothers could do, even though I was the oldest. So, a lot of things I didn't know about. You know, but it was like I was searching for something and I didn't know where to find it. So, one day I saw this guy at my high school and he caught my eye like immediately. And I was the type, I was quiet and standoffish and shy. And he would have never knew that I had a thing for him. So, if I can remember correctly, eventually either one of my friends, I wrote a note. That was so corny now. Thinking. I wrote a note to him, or she went and told him, like, she liked you, you know, and found out he was kind of feeling me too. So I'm all, you know, happy and stuff. And every time I saw him, I had butterflies in my stomach, like, and the biggest smile on my face. Like, dang. I didn't know I could feel this way. I was around probably like 17 years old. I don't know. I don't know. I started everything late. But we would talk on the phone and stuff. And I would have to sneak to talk on the phone because really wasn't supposed to talk to boys. I stayed with my grandma, so she wasn't happening. So I would talk to him or whatever. We would talk. And I would have to call him. It was a big deal for me to get my own line. So couldn't get that. But we still talked. We talked at school, you know. And let me see. It was like, he was nice to me, you know. Then when I was probably a senior. And I graduated and everything. And then, we still, you know, kept in touch, but one of my friends would take me, she was driving, I wasn't, she would take me to his aunt's house, so she'll drop me off, or whatever, over there for a few hours, so, well, we never did anything, we just, was the average teenagers, I guess. my memory's kind of blurry, but I remember just the happiest times with him. I was so happy. He made my insides just have a party, you know. So, somehow he left. We lost contact or something. He came back, and I was pregnant. I had moved on. He left, so I didn't think I'll see him again. I don't even know where he went, but I was pregnant when he came back. And I broke the news to him. I had just found out too, my first son. I'm like, ooh, you know. He's not gonna want to talk to me now, you know. I'm not good, so it hurt him. He was a little bothered, like, dang, really, you know. And I'm like, yeah, I just found out or whatever. So he was like, you know, it was all good. We still kicked it and stuff, and he still liked me and stuff. So I still liked him. So, we went to the haunted house. I was like 5 months pregnant, 4 or 5 months pregnant, and we went to the haunted house together. I wasn't supposed to go. My grandma knew that. She don't know. She never knew that I went to the haunted house. She has this thing with, if you're pregnant, you're not supposed to see a crazy looking stuff, so I didn't tell her. And so we went, we had fun or whatever, and it dropped me back off at home. Then I had moved into an apartment, and my kid's dad, I don't think we were, my child's father, I don't think we were together. He was on some other type of stuff. He wasn't, I don't know what he was on, but he would sneak in the house in the middle of the night, take a shower. So I knew what that meant. Like, I'm not stupid. So I'm like, okay. So we weren't really together like that. He's kind of stayed there when he wanted to, basically, when he wanted to just drop by and one night. So happened. He left. He walked away. I think that was my last time seeing him. And it was heartbreaking because I knew that I still had feelings for him, and that this is who I wanted to be with. Like, you know. And I knew, like, he's not gonna wanna talk to me no more. He's mad. He's not gonna. And I guess I gave up because of that. I didn't even try to. I don't think I even called, or I don't know if he was taking my calls. I don't know. But that was the end of us. I don't. Sad story. I just had to suck it up. And realize, you know, that I may never see him again in life. But a few years ago, I did see him. We were at a party at a mutual friend's house, and I saw him. And he looked the same. I know I do. I'm like, dang, did he remember me? I wonder, you know, is he, you know. And I saw him looking like he knew me from somewhere, but I wasn't sure if he did remember me. Wasn't sure if he was with the girl, anybody there, whatever he was. So I'm like, okay. I came there with my brother. So maybe months on end, not too long ago, we connected on Facebook, and he inboxed me, like, you know, I'm trying to remember where I know you from. I know it wasn't from school. Did we talk? Blah, blah, blah. I had surgery in September, so my memory's kind of whack. So I'm like, I remembered that. I remembered all that, like, majority of it anyway. I ran it down, honey. I ran it all down. And he remembered. He was like, oh, I used to, you know, like you and a lot. And he reminded me of the part, the ending part, because I really didn't know what had happened. But I apologized. I was sorry. I didn't. We were young, though. We were so young. We were. And I just needed to know, was he holding it against me in any way or whatever? And he said he's not. But now I'm in a place where, well, we're friends. And we're going to continue, I guess, to be friends. And you know, what the Lord can ask for. We need to... Do we catch up, you know, could we talk or whatever, you know, exchange numbers, blah, blah, blah. We've talked a few times and stuff, and catching up. And well, I'm in a place right now where I'm not getting in a relationship no time soon, being that I just ended a 6-year one, and I'm in a place where in that 6-year, I mean, I know I have spoken to so many females, like, just dealing with them on a level that, are you messing with my man type stuff, and I'm on the other side of the table, like, I'm in a place where I can't do that now, like, so this time here is just for me. I'm just chilling. We could be cool, whatever, but I'm just being careful because I don't have time to be into it with nobody's chick, you know, and no chick calling my phone, texting my phone, and all that. So, but honestly, you know, I would want to be in a relationship again, but this time it has to be, I have to know it's for keeps, and this man is going to respect me and love me for me. But I'm going to end this story time now. Be happy, be right for you, and I will talk to you later.